Today I am Fer Carlo Pascual of BSN2F, and today I will be performing the normal delivery. For the assessment, ensure the privacy and dignity of the woman. Make her feel comfortable. A male doctor should have a female assistant while performing the examination. Ask if she understood what's going to be done with the procedure and ask for her permission before undertaking the examination. All equipment, medicine, and disposables should be prepared before the pregnant woman is brought into the delivery room. The woman is to be brought on the labor table in the stage of labor. Unnecessary pushing in between contractions should be avoided. Ensure that the woman is hydrated and empty the bladder before encouraging her to push. All neonatal equipment for ENBC and for resuscitation should be pre-checked and be made ready before the woman is brought in. The room temperature should range from between 26 to 28 degrees Celsius in the labor room, and chilly areas should have a heater during the winter. Provide support and reassurance if visible, and encourage to have a birth companion. For the planning, prepare all the equipment needed. Jelly pad, drainage pail, sterile OB pack. This includes the gown dressing and the OB sheet. The drape towel with or without equipment or instruments. Sterile gloves, normal delivery sets. Arrange depending on the order used. Sterile pads, suction bulb, two pairs of straight forceps, one pair of surgical scissors, placental bowl, syringe 5 to 10 milliliters, and hypodermic needles for the aspiration needle gauge is 19 to 21. For the injecting gauge, 21 to 23. Then we will need chromic needle holder, thumb forceps, and tissue forceps. Now for the implementation. For the implementation, change into the DR suit. Next is to wear personal protective equipment such as goggles, face mask, cups, shoe covers, and a plastic apron. Next is to palpate the supra pubis of the mother, and if it's hard, ask the mother to empty her bladder or catheterize it. Now we'll wash our hands and don in our sterile gloves. Next is to clean the perineum of the woman with sterile swabs. Thank you. Okay, now that we're all set, I will now proceed to the gloving. Since I don't have a sterile glove, so I will be using a surgical glove for the gloving technique. Okay, now we're all set. Okay, now please breathe through your nose. And I'll be coming. Push. Baby owl, 6:06 p.m. in the afternoon, and it's a baby boy. Friend's mother, it is a baby boy. towards the big group. And then we cut it. And then we pull what's left of the placenta. And it took the placenta bowl. Next is to inject. Next is to inject 10 cc 10 units of oxytocin through IM to the mother. For the evaluation, maintain aseptic technique throughout the procedure. Cleaning up of the labor table immediately after the transfer of the mother to the postnatal or the observation ward. For the documentation, do the charting. Then after the normal delivery, we will do the essential newborn care. For the essential newborn care assessment, prepare for the delivery, perineal bulging with presenting past visible or the second stage of labor. Next is to check the room temperature from 25 to 28 degrees Celsius, and there should be no air draft. And lastly, notify the staff. X is the planning. Prepare the equipments needed. 3 sets of surgical gloves. 2 warm blankets. 1 bonnet. Cord care set, which are the heli scissors and cord clamp. Next is the ophthalmic eye ointment, vitamin K, hepatitis B shot, functional resuscitation equipment, and these are all arranged in a linear fashion. And check resuscitation equipment. For the implementation, wash hands, put on the gloves. Put on the gloves by doing the double gloving technique. Within the first 30 seconds, immediate and thorough drying. Next is to call out the time of the birth once the baby is delivered from the perineum. Then do the rapid assessment to the newborn for at least 30 seconds. Wipe the face, arms, eyes, front, back, and legs, and arms. Next is the time band after the 30 seconds, which is the skin-to-skin contact. We will now remove the wet cloth and change in the dry cloth, and position the newborn in a prone position on the abdomen of the mother, and cover the newborn with a dry blanket and a bonnet on his head. Next is the time band of 1 to 3 minutes. This would be the cord clamping. Now remove the first set of gloves, then clamp the cord from 2 centimeters from the umbilical base. Then apply the clamp on the base of the umbilicus and cut the cord close to the plastic clamp. For the time band of 90 minutes, the non-separation of newborn to the mother for early breastfeeding. Now we will inject 10 units of oxytocin to the mother via intramuscular. Then leave the newborn in skin-to-skin contact with the mother. Then next is to observe the feeding cues, including the tonguing and the sucking reflex or the rooting reflexes. And point this out to the mother and encourage her to nudge the newborn to her breast. Next is to counsel on positioning, attachment, and suckling, and check for any congenital malformation. Now while doing the skin-to-skin contact, check for the mother's condition and the placenta. Next is the examination, eye care, injection of hepatitis B shot, BCG, and vitamin K. Next is the weighing and bathing will be done after the full process of breastfeeding. Finally, postpone the washing for at least 6 hours.
Raven's mother, like this little baby boy. we got it. This is the angel. Next is the angel, 10 to 0. 10 units of oxytocin through IM to the mother.
For the evaluation and documentation, evaluate the newborn by doing the Apgar scoring, Anderson and Silverman scoring, and the Ballard scoring test, and document the findings.